Hey everyone, and welcome to Stephanie Reacts to The Legend of Korra. Well, I'm actually enjoying this book, so I'm actually glad I've watched all of this, so I'm happy to jump back into this. So this is Book 1, Air, Chapter 3, The Revelation. What could the revelation be? Maybe that she has to go travel the world to learn all the other elements, maybe. She already knows about fire, I think. She can do fire. She can do earth and water. So I think it's only air. But she may have to travel the world to learn more air. Because as we saw with Aang, he travelled the world to learn three elements. He was. So maybe Korra's to do that. Maybe to try and learn air. But I'll be getting it. Well, let's jump into this now and see what the revelation's all about, starting now. Revelation, Chapter 3. Ooh! Thought it was going to come and hit my face, yeah?
Where are the rookies?
The morning is evil. That was good.
That's impossible.
The snow.
Only the Avatar has ever possessed that ability.
But I saw him do it.
Yeah. That villain guy. He was today help his brother. He wanted to. That's why he went to join the triad kind of thing. Cause that guy who's showed up and gave him the big stack of cash in his bucket. That was a good thing, him getting the cash, aye. But he knew what he was getting himself into. And he knew it was going to be trouble. And he was captured for it. And who is the revelation people? We saw them episode 1. It's for a loan. Why give them the money if you had to get it all back? Just say, I've got your money here, but you owe me this, you owe me that, you owe me that. So I can't give you it and just shove it in his pocket. I should be giving him it and start taking it all off him again. Eh? But the funny thing I've got in this, it was at the very start, it was when Korra's on. Why first thing in the morning? Mornings are evil. I liked it when she said mornings are evil. Some mornings are evil, some not. I'm a night owl, most of the time. I go to bed about like 5 in the morning. Sometimes, I've done it the last 3 nights in a row. I woke up back at 8 or 9 in the morning, I have. So about 3 or 4 hours sleep I've had. I'm tired every day, cause of that. Oh. But, mornings are sometimes evil if I got up too early, you know, like, time is it? Not back to sleep. It was like back at 7 or back at 8 I wake up, I done, not back to sleep. If it's back at 9 or 10, I'll stay awake. I will. So don't want to be asleep for too long and all that and sleep the whole day away. Because if I sleep the whole day away, I won't have time for my reactions. I'll do my reactions in the mornings. That's why I've got the whole day to myself to either play Super Mario 35, Among Us, the Super Mario 64 or whatever on the Switch, Pokemon Sword, see, or watch YouTube. But mornings are alright for reactions, yeah. But Korra could probably do a training during the day or maybe at night. I know I got off topic there, I did, but aye. Let's see what the next episode's called. The voice in, I'm guessing, the night. Also shows me an eye at the minute. Aye, the voice in the night. Had to go to edit title to get the full thing. The voice in the night. Who could that be? Oh aye, before I get into that voice in the night, I think about it. Tenza, I think his name is, or Tenzin. Something like that. Aang's son. Says only the Avatar can take away bending. So that's what we saw Aang day to the Fire Lord. take away his bending powers. So when he says only the Avocado can do that, and when he says what the other guy can do, then he shouldn't be able to do that. So watch, he is a dangerous person. How did he get the powers of an avatar? To take away people's bending powers that way. See, you heard him talking about saying the gods came to him or something, or the four elements came to him and told him how to take away bending powers. I think that's... No, I don't think. Because, like, the four elements, when you just go to a person, it's like, you see, Aang getting into the avatar state, you see all his past selves sometimes talking to him. You sort of see that with Korra, or getting into I think all avatars can go into the avatar state, if they can. You might see Korra going into the avatar state, like, maybe near the end of the volume, so somebody's feeling danger. She goes into the avatar state, and she sounds like supernova on people, maybe. But anyway, as I was just going to say, the voice in the night. Maybe it's that Revelation team, like whispering, this guy who can stop bending powers, join the Revelation, or this old gang up in the Avatar when she's not looking, or get her when she's sleeping at night time. That could be like the voice in the night, people whispering during the night. I don't know. I just hope nothing happens to Korra. I know there are a couple of books, two more books I think, or three more books. But Korra could get a bending power took off her, and you can't bend anymore. Then she might have to learn how to bend again. And that's where all these other books are from. It's where she learns different elements. Probably like we saw Ice, or we saw from Toph's daughter, steel bending. Maybe she has to learn you can just fight in steel if she gets her bending power to Kaffa with this person. I don't know. But that's in my theory, the next episode kind of thing. She might get her bending power to Kaffa. So until then, everyone, thank you very much for the support and for all your views and comments and likes and subscribe not Tuesday. Thank you for all this. And everyone, as I always say, you know the rule. Have a good day, good night, good week, good weekend. Look after yourselves. Stay indoors if you have to. If you can't stay indoors, then look after yourselves. Please look after yourselves. You just mean the world to everyone these days. So until then, I'll see you then. The next one. Bye, everyone.